It's a national treasure that draws in nearly 3 million visitors per year. So when a 20-foot portion of the historic Newport Cliff Walk fell on what was a storm-free, nice weather day, it's no wonder people are wondering what happened and why. And could our changing climate be creating more of a challenge?
We went to the first half of the cliff walk, and it was really great, and we enjoyed it a lot. But then we got to the end, and we saw that there was this big detour.
The detour is a temporary solution to allow visitors to continue to enjoy the cliff walk during the projected long recovery process, which will stretch through the busy summer tourism season.
The last time something this catastrophic happened was during Hurricane Sandy, when, you know, waves out in the ocean were crashing up on the land side 30, 40, 50, 60 feet.
But the reasoning behind this massive crumble isn't as black and white.
Subtle increases in groundwater and just water level of the ocean change the way that land-water interface kind of work. And so all of a sudden you reach a certain pressure point that says, I have to fall, right? Or I have to collapse in this area.
According to NOAA, the sea level in Newport has risen more than 10 inches over the past century. So now the challenge is what to do next.
You have to retrain the way that you think about kind of design and approaches to coastal-based assets.
Kirk works with a team of scientists to develop nature-based approaches to climate adaptations and coastal resilience.
Things like living shorelines or offshore reefs, more softer kind of nature-based solutions that might, you know, help protect an asset like the cliff walk from erosion by reducing wave energy or erosional pressures in that area.
But this solution might not be enough to withstand the strong erosional pressure this coastal site faces, with drops as high as 70 feet. Still, finding a solution is worth the challenge, as it is a truly beloved escape to nature.
We really like to be outside. I love the ocean.
It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. It's Newport.
Engineers are still studying and exploring the root of the cause for the collapse. But one thing is for certain, our more extreme weather and our sea level rise are factors that will play a part in the decision to either rebuild or retreat. Either way, this New England landmark will live on for generations to explore. In Newport, Rhode Island, I'm meteorologist Kellyanne Chalice.